Hello my friends, I'm YouTubeBikeas and this is a video about complaining for some stuff on the Super Street Fighter Arcade Edition that they make us to buy and download some others from the PSN. Okay, for starters, I love the game. I don't hate the game. I have played the game. I own a PlayStation 3. I already have the game. I downloaded the DLC. I didn't buy the retail disc, because I didn't want to waste any money, because I don't have many money the last 1 year. And it was much cheaper for me to go in the PSN and download the update for the Street Fighter. The update for the Super Street Fighter arcade that they make us to download and some others to buy it was in fact a really cheap move from Capcom, because they actually want to make us go out and buy the fucking retail disc. And why is that? Because they actually didn't put in the downloadable update that we make the trials for the characters. The first and big mistake that they make. It's a simple update. They can actually put it on the servers of the Capcom, and I don't know how they do it in the Capcom, and just make us download the update so we can have the whole new arcade version of the actual game. And I'll say that because I love the game and I want the whole package, not the half of it. Because the trials of the characters is something important on the game. When I buy the disc, all the trials from the already existed characters was inside the disc. And I don't understand why Capcom didn't make that happen in the DLC that we make on our consoles. And I know why Capcom do that, because they want us to go out there in some fucking store and buy the fucking retail disc, so we can pay the double price of the particular DLC. Because in the DLC we can give them $15, but in the retail disc we can give them $25 and $30, and this is much more money for them to earn as well. Am I wrong? No, I'm not wrong, because most of us need some more respect, like buyers, like consumers, and not only. And this is really cheap move, Capcom, trust me on that. Another thing that bugs me a lot was the actual balancing that they make on the characters. And if you combine this balancing that they make with the new characters, especially Evil Ryu and Oni, some out there you are going to eat dust. Trust me on that, you are going to break your nerves so fucking mad and take your console or the disc and throw it out of the window. Believe me on that. Because with those particular characters, especially those two that I mentioned, even a baby can beat you. Yes, it's really easy. Just repeat the fucking moves over and over again. It's easy, very easy. I have tried myself and it works in many, many parts. Works really great. I love those characters because they are cheaters. And not only the characters, because it's not only the character's fault, it's the company's fault as well, because they make us a balancing that they actually promise us that the game will run much smoother, you are going to make your combos much easier and stuff like that. This is shit, Capcom, okay? Stop doing that. It's not good. Correct those mistakes and fix that fucking balancing. And I know why that happened, my friends. Because some 12-year-old children out there and whiners complained about the balancing of the game, and of course Capcom decided to make it much better by making it worse. Thank you, my friends. Thank you, my whiners. I know that you are going to hate me about this and send me many hate messages, but I write you in my dick, as we Greeks say, in our language. Of course, my friends, I'm not here only to complain about the mistakes that they make, but I'm here also to give some new ideas to Capcom, if they want to listen to me, of course, so they can do the game much bigger and, of course, much more fun that already is. For example, in the first Street Fighter disc that they made, Street Fighter 4, they have put a theater that you can actually see the endings of each character. I don't understand why you removed that Capcom, because it was a good idea, like Tekken from Namco, that they can actually put the endings of each character so you can see them. And I love those cinematics, I love those collections, I love to play the game so I can unlock those particular stuff. Those details are make the game bigger and cooler in some particular parts. Not in all parts, of course, because the game, it's the game, it's a Street Fighter, we all know that. Another good idea would be actually a great thing for the replay channel to make some replays and record them. So you can actually upload them some to YouTube or every other channel or on the PSN, so you can share your fights with some other guys much better. It's not that I don't like the replay channel, but it's a lame idea in some particular parts. The only thing that I was worked with that was the actual trophy that you can sit and watch 30 matches, I think, I don't remember, and take the freaking trophy. I'm not a trophy fan. I have collected as many as I can because I'm an average player. I'm not a burnt player or anything, if you hear me out there, people. But it would be a great idea, like Square Enix, that they actually make it that reality on the PSP console with the Final Fantasy Dissidia. You can actually record your replay and then take it and upload it everywhere you want. By make down in the corner the copyright infringements with the company's name, of course, and stuff like that. It's easy, Capcom. It's not an idea that you actually must have brains to make it. And it's a good idea, I believe. Another good idea would be that you can actually see your own personal records saved on your hard disk and displayed after some time when you actually play the game and write your initials, like an arcade game, because it's actually the arcade edition. I believe that it will be a good idea, because those will be your personal records and not only your online records. I believe that this actually feature exists in the arcade retail disc, but I'm not going out there to buy it, because I don't want to do that. I love the game as it is, because I have it, I have downloaded the update. I love the update, except those two big complaints that I have. And I thought that it would be a good idea to mention it, though I don't know about the rest of you guys. And one final good idea that I have on the particular video was to put another character that I wanted to see so much in this game, because we already have two Final Fight characters, Guy and Cody. And of course I'm talking about Mike Hagar, the mayor of the Metro City. I wanted to see him, that guy, in a DLC or something. I was going to pay to see him to play, because it would be a good thing for that. A very good thing to see another Final Fight guy in that particular game, Mike Hagar. And I will believe that it would be a really great opportunity to play in a Street Fighter game as a new newcomer, of course, as a newcomer character. Thank you, my friends, for sitting down and watch that particular video about my complaints and my ideas for the Super Street Fighter Arcade Edition. I don't want any one of you take me wrong, and I don't want, especially I don't want haters to go down and get on my face and start to swearing on me about the game and about that I have mistakes or anything. I don't have anything with anyone, not even with Capcom, because I love that company, because I play the games of that freaking company many years now. Especially Street Fighter, I love Street Fighter, one of my favorite beat 'em ups, of course. And I would love to see some from the Capcom comment me and tell me what they are going to do in the future, so they can correct those mistakes and not making them much worse than they already are. Thanks for watching again, dudes. I don't want any complaints about my video again. And I hope that Capcom see that video and change their minds about some stuff in the way they're selling their games and the DLCs, of course.